All right, we're back in the garage. It's spring, so it's time to get the old bike ready. One thing I've been kind of sitting on the end of last year. Yep, certainly nailed it. So I've got my new tire. It was almost time anyway. You can see the tread is getting low. So it was time for a new one anyway. So this is actually forcing me to do it now. And then since I'm going to be taking it all apart, I'm going to go ahead and put some new brakes on it in the back. So we got those ready. And then of course I got some weights here so I can balance the tire. But it shouldn't be too bad, I don't think. All right, so we've got the bike up on a center stand. And with that, my rear wheel is loose. I'm going to remove this pin. Let me see that, a pin and a nut here. I've got this nut here for the brake, and then we've got a pin over here as well, and a nut and the washer, and hopefully the axle will come out. I'm actually going to put probably a 2x4 under here too, just to support it a little bit, so the axle will come out easier without all the weight of the tire just, sitting on it. So I'm having some trouble getting this axle nut off. And what's happening is when I'm turning it, the whole axle is just turning. There's nothing over here I can really grip onto. I've tried to, put a screwdriver in here and hold it, but it's just turning. So I've been spraying the crap out of it, WD-40. Been using this big guy here. Got the socket, and I was hitting it with this hammer, this giant one, just try to loosen on impact, but every time I do it, the whole axle is just turning. And people are saying you can use a flame, a torch, but I mean this piece is just a couple bucks, so I think I'm gonna take the Dremel. I'm just gonna cut it off. All right, you can see where I cut into it. Had to be really careful not to get too deep, but just put a couple of cuts, one this way, one that way, and then one going along this way too. Hit it with a small chisel, and then when I took this guy to it, it popped right away. So we're loose now. Should be able to get that off. It's off, so I'll just get a new castle nut, and you can see the cut I put in it. Didn't take too much, just enough that it's a little leeway so it'll pop when we give it some torque. It's off. I just want to remember the direction that this thing goes. You want to slide this guy out of here. That's all that takes. Don't lose your spring. This thing here needs to come off. There we go, and it looks like we're loose now. Right, now the axle needs to come out. So I'll try to just hit it with a hammer. Hitting it with a hammer directly, what I'm doing is I'm putting this nut back on, but not all the way. Now that way when I hit it, it'll actually be hitting the nut. So I don't want to cause this to mushroom, the axle to mushroom. So this nut, I'm going to replace it anyway, so I don't care if I beat it up a little bit. Really didn't have to hit it too hard. And it's coming loose over here. See, I got a little tiny, about half an inch here, and I'm going to see if I can just pull it out now. Oh yeah. See that? No problem at all. I've got the tire kind of propped up a little bit so the weight of the wheel is not sitting on the axle as I pull this out. I'm gonna stop the video though just so this doesn't come crashing down when I get it all the way out. So it's out, it's got the spacer that slid right off. So I put that back on just so I wouldn't lose where that was. And then this whole piece almost comes out, but I want to try to get the wheel off right now. And I think to do that, what I'll do is just pull on it, and I think it'll just come off because this is a drive shaft. I think it'll just come off of the shaft in there without me having to take the rest of this off. So let's see how this goes. Right, we're off. What I did is I just turned the wheel slightly backwards and then pulled on it this direction a little bit, and it just slid right off. So we're free. And you gotta be careful because all this can fall out over here. All right, we're off. And let's see. So there's where the shaft connects. It's got a lot of grease on it. I've got a mask on now. These old brakes say that there's asbestos dust. So let's take a look here. That's pretty dirty. These pads, they're not gone, but we're not looking great. As long as I've had this bike, it's never been off. That's been maybe 6 years now. Quickly note to myself, this little piece sits right in here. Oops, I missed it. It sits in there. And that's what goes through the brake here. And then these guys, that big bolt, is what goes on the back side of this. And the bolt sits in there. There's a little, it's goes up into the metal. And it's, let's see if we can look here. Sorry about the lighting and my shop light there. There we go. You can see where the bolt sits in there. And it supports it from turning on that side. And this, I'm going to spray down with the brake cleaner really good after I get these old ones out. To get these off, you don't fight with the springs. You just can pull this up. See, this one will also come up like that. See that dust? I'm wearing a mask right now. I should be doing this outside, but these just pop right off. That's it. And I'm going to take some brake cleaner and spray this down. I spray the inside of the hub down. Look at that. That cleaned up really well. And there's the inside. That's what the pads or the shoes clip onto. I don't know if you remember that before. This was almost completely black. So this, the brake cleaner, just spray it down really well, wipe it down, repeat, and get it looking almost new again. That looks great. All right, just a quick side by side. Make sure the new parts like they'll align all right. Everything fits. These springs look like they're quite a bit smaller, but I'm sure they stretch out. They came as one package. So you see how much bigger these pads are. Now that these are gone, put these shoes in. You can see this has a couple of flat sides on it. And that's actually what pushes the shoes apart and into the drum of the wheel to stop it. And these guys have a flat side and a round side. And pretty obvious, oops, which goes where. And these, when I pull them apart, they do actually get a little bit longer. But just like when I took them off, I want to turn them both up this direction and then put the spring in so that they clip without me having to pull on it, and then force them both down together so they stay in. All right, since I've got this apart, one thing I want to do is I want to lubricate up all the pivot points on the brake. Just so here and inside there. My brake kind of was getting stuck before it gets stuck down. So I'm going to take the screw out. You can see I've kind of already started. Put a mark here where the line was so I can make sure I put this back on the same way. Take the screw out. And now I'm just working it off. Here it is apart. This guy slides out then. And then we'll lubricate it up in here. We'll clean up the old stuff and lubricate it up. And then there's also, I believe, this thing. Try to clean that up a little bit too. I don't think there's much we can do about that. That seems to be cloth. Okay, so I cleaned up all inside there. You can see how it's nice and shiny. Clean this up everywhere I could. I'm going to grease it up now. And I've got this this brake caliper grease that I use on my front brake. It's made for high heat. So I'm just going to use it on these pivot points. I was reading that it should be safe to use, and it's just this blue synthetic caliper grease. But I'm just going to use it in here, and then also I'll put a little bit on here too. You've got to be extra careful not to get any of it on the brake itself. Go. And we can see how that works. Really quite a simple design. I'm going to let the air out of this tire, and I'm just going to use my I've got a tire gauge, just not put it on all the way. There you go. All right, I'm trying to pop this tire bead without special tools. I tried just a normal clamp first. I couldn't get this to work. Tried jumping on it and all that. So what I'm going to do now, I don't know if this is something people do, probably. I've got a little block of wood down here, up here. I jacked up my car just a little bit. And I want to make sure this isn't going to come down on the rim. And I'm just going to slowly lower this down. And the weight of the car, hopefully will pop this. So we'll see how this goes. All right, so I did not get it on camera, but I did get it to pop. I had to raise everything up just a little bit more, so the tire was completely off the ground. But you can see here that the bead is off. So mission accomplished. All right, we're doing the other side. So you see the bead is broken on this top side. I've got a piece of wood down there. Got to make sure it's not touching the rim, but it's close to it. And then I've got it raised up a little bit more off the ground, and then one over here too. And then we're just going to lower the car. I've got metal. You want to make sure you're on metal on the car. And I'm just going to lower it down now, and hopefully that other bead pops. All right, well, the little jack did its job. Got the bead now popped on both sides. You can see that the rim is totally loose. There we go.
And that said, so now we'll get some soapy water, peel this thing off.
Now to get this tire off, some people buy special plastic to put in here and protect your rim. What I've done is I took, I got this container and I had nuts, and I keep these around because they're good for things, and I just cut it a little bit. And, you know, good enough so I can just slide it in to protect my rim. One here, and then I'll take a bar of some sort, jam it down in there, and pull the tire over the top. See what I got. It's maybe one of these or one of these. Jam it in, protect the rim. You definitely don't want to scratch it up. Just pull the tire over the top. Forgot to mention, get some soapy water too, and you spray it all around there. That way it lubricates it up a little bit. All right, so quickly I'll just show you. I put the plastic down in there, the long piece is in, and this wraps around the edge of the rim. You got these two ready to go. And then you start lifting up and you pull the tire up over the top of the rim. You'll do one and do the other one. And then you should, once you have the first two out, then you move over and just keep going around the rest of the rim and it should pop off. So I got the first two. I'm gonna leave this one in here. I moved the plastic over a little bit. Jam the bar down in there. We'll see how this does now. Yeah, I'm gonna need both hands for this. I just don't want something popping out and hit me in the shin. And there it came. Looks like maybe just one more time around and we'll have this tire half off. Didn't even have to put one more in. I just basically put some more of my soapy water on it, lube it up a little bit, and I was able to just pull it off. So we got half of it over the rim. Now I got to do the other side, and it's very similar. I'll just put the plastic in again to protect the rim. Shove the pry bar through all the way to the other side. Bring it off. First I came in this side just to get through, and then I put one into the back side. I don't want to lift that up, but now you can see that when I lift this, and that tire is about ready to pop off that rim. So I'm just going to make sure it's nice and lubricated and kind of work my way around just a little bit. But you know, I mean, all I did is I stood on it here. It helps that there's no brake caliper on mine. You see I've got this plastic fold up underneath just so it's softer on the rim a little bit. I just stood on it here, pull it from the tire, thing it just peeled right off. And you do all that without damaging the rim. It feels nice and smooth still. Something else I'm going to do while I'm in here is replace the valve stem, because there's just never going to be an easier time to do it. And so just got to unscrew these guys, and then the stem should just come right up that way. All right, so I got one of the nuts out. The other one's loose. And you can see the washer is here too, so we'll take all this off. And then out it comes. And you can see, so there's the gasket, the old gasket. We'll go pick up a new one. We'll wash this down so it's nice and clean. Put a new one in. All right, so I'll quickly show you the valve stem before I put the new one in. Obviously, this was the old one. It wasn't leaking or anything, but again, it's just there's not going to be an easier time to replace this. And because it's a metal valve stem, I probably could just replace the gasket and then this washer. And I probably could have gotten away with it for the time being. But this is not a regular valve stem. It's not something you can go to like an AutoZone and get this. That's one thing about working with these old bikes, is they have a lot of unique parts that you have to get from a Kawasaki motorcycle dealer directly or online somewhere. And the same thing with So that castle nut that I cut, you know, I got my new one here, and it was like $5. And again, it's not something that you can get at O'Reilly's or somewhere like that. So I got those. I'm going to go ahead and install my my new one. I'll keep the old one around just in case I ever need it someday. Because new one, I mean, it's like too expensive. It's like $15 for one of these. But again, you know, most of the time is spent taking the wheel off of the hub. So what's $15 versus having to do it all over again? All right,
the new valve stem is in. You know, you want to make it tight, but not so tight that it rips this rubber. Before we put the tire on the rim, a couple of things we want to take note of. I've got it just sitting in front of my shop. I'm trying to heat it up to make the rubber a little bit easier to work with. If you set it out in the sun, that should help. I don't think that's really going to do a whole lot. But we want to make sure we put it on the right way, first of all. So if we look, where is it at? Oh, right here. It says drive that direction. So we got to be sure the bike is facing this way, that it's going to be rolling. So I got it upside down right now. There we go. Yeah, so drive this way. Perfect. And then we got to make sure that the wheel is also the right direction. So I know that this is the part that attaches to the drive shaft. There's my brake. So we got it going the right way. The other thing we want to take note of is there's going to be this dot on the tire, and that will align with the valve stem. It should help when you balance the tire. They have tried to, that's where it is pre-balanced. So that should help with the balancing if you get that lined up when you put the tire on. So, turn this over. So that goes down. We don't need it perfect just yet, but we'll get it close. Now, I've cleaned up the rim. I took a rag and I wiped down the tire and the rim itself. So I'll take some soapy water now, and we'll do the reverse of what we did before. I'll soap down the whole thing and grab my tools, my plastic, and we'll work it back on. Show you quickly what I'm doing here. You start about a third of the way across, put one of them in, the other one in, and then you just pull up on them like that. You want to be sure you don't you get it down inside here and not through here. Right here is where the beads sit. You don't want to scratch this part. So when you stick your bar in, make sure you get it down deep. And then I always use my plastic piece, my thick plastic piece too, to help avoid scratches. And then put your knees on it to push it down in, and then you lift it up on both sides. This one, I'm keeping it in place because it's a little thicker. This thin one's a little easier to slide in. So I just start here, pull up on them both, put your knees on it to keep it in, work your way up around to the next one, pull up on them both, move your knees up on both of them, and then I'm going to just keep one around. I also got my my soapy water sprayed on too. It acts as lubricant, you know, to help the tire slide on. So you might need more of that if you don't get it on in time. Showing some progress here. When you pull up on this, you really gotta slam your weight down with your knees, and you'll feel the tire go over the top of the rim. Look at that, we're on. Got one side. Now, something really similar over here. Now, don't forget to get this lined up as best as you can before you start putting it on. It'll help with your balancing later on. And another thing you don't want to do, stick this in right where the valve stem is and damage that rubber. So avoid that as well. All right, it's the same kind of thing. Put this one in, Start here, lift it up, get it over the top, move it over, lift it up, move it over, lift it up. Get your knee there to hold in place. I want to keep going around. About halfway there. All right, and then for the end of it, you want to make sure that you push this down into the middle of the tire, or that you push the tire down into the middle of the wheel where it sits in, because that lets it pull forward a little bit. If you don't do that, you'll never get it on. So what I did is I stood, you get it down in there, and I stood with both sides and then finished up around this side. Keep it lubed up. If you're not sweating by the end of this, and good on you. Now we'll got my pump. This is just a cheap little guy. Hopefully it's good enough. And I'll put some air in here. If the bead's not holding right away, what I can do is you can take a strap and put it around the outside, tighten it down, and that'll help hold the bead as you put air in it. But I'm gonna try without it first, so we'll see if it holds on its own. So I was having no luck with this little pump getting the bead to pop. So what I've done is I put this strap around there and all the way around, tighten it up, and it puts more pressure in there. So I'm gonna try it now. Let's see if it'll hold.
Haven't quite popped yet.
Loosen this up. Seems to be holding. All right, the strap did it. One thing I needed to do was put the handle right where the tire was definitely down in the middle. And because if you saw half of it, the bead was on, and the other half it was off. So I put this part where it was off, because it really, this was where most of the force, when you're tightening it, it was making the tire go down in and forcing it out. So that was the trick. So what I'm going to do, they say you should bounce it a couple times like a basketball, make sure it's really set, and then we'll check it for leaks. Got done bouncing it. Let's use my little sprayer here, and we'll check. Spray all the way around. This might not be soapy enough. I'm going to get some more soap. We're all soaked up. Go all the way around. And that's not good. Nah, that's not good at all. That's what a leak looks like. But you know what? I think the bead just popped. I heard a pop. So maybe it just wasn't quite set in there. Look at that, I think it stopped. That's why you don't stick your fingers in there. Wow, well that about broke my heart. Okay, cool. So that bead needed to be set still. Those are old. Wow, okay, I'm gonna check the other side. But looking at it, I think I can kind of tell. So the rest of it looks like it's sitting pretty well. So this is the other side. Got a little space here. So my guess is the same thing's gonna happen, where I'll spray some soap on it. We'll see it start bubbling up, and then it'll lubricate it enough to where the bead will slide out and sit. Hopefully. See how this does. I'm not seeing bubbles anywhere. Okay, well, I'm going to bounce this one a couple more times and see if we can get this to come out like the rest of it. See how over here the water is like, it's sitting on top. But here it just kind of, it fell down in there and you can't even see it. Still not popping. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let some air out of the tire and try to refill it. That time, right? All right. Now I checked before, the max PSI of this tire is 40. So I wasn't even near that. But you got to keep an eye on that. You don't want to go to the max when you're doing this. And this tire is only supposed to be about 25 on the bike. So I'm quite happy that that's popped and it's no longer making a bunch of bubbles. So I'm going to put this tire back down to pressure and we'll check for leaks one more time. Now, you can see we got no air bubbles coming up. And the rim, when you look at it up close, it's definitely tight all the way around. Check the other side. And this is looking good. There's something here I'm gonna splice in after the fact, but there's a line so you can see if the tire is actually all the way on the rim and the bead has popped. You can kind of see this line here. And when you go all the way around, you'll see that is lined up perfectly here with the rim. And if the bead has not popped, then that line is not going to be set. So that's something I found out after the fact. So now to balance this tire, since I had the straps out, you can see I just put it to length. Is it just the extra dangling here, and put the axle in, and now it will just spin on that. And then to check and make sure, I've been eyeballing it with my level to make sure it's pretty close to level. Obviously helps when it's done swinging, but yeah, so once I get that level, then we can do the balancing. We're looking nice and level. I can see the old weights are still on there at the bottom, so I'm likely just going to take those off. But what you want to do is make sure that the strap isn't touching any part of this. Yeah, see how it's just immediately falling with those weights down to the bottom. So I'm going to pull those weights off. Those are the old ones. Right to the bottom. Make sure the strap isn't touching here, and we'll try this again. Okay, so the weights are off there. I just took a screwdriver. They just stick on, and you just pry it and peel them off. And the valve stem went straight to the bottom. So let's just verify that's not by accident. Just spin it lightly. We'll, stop it out here. And then see if it falls. And look at that, immediately we're going right down. My guess is it's going to get about halfway up and then turn direction, because
Apparently it's heavier down there where that valve stem is. All right, so what I'm gonna do is add some weight at the opposite side, and we'll try again. And these are the weights I got, lead-free. They probably used lead previously. That's good that it doesn't have it. You can just pick these up at any hardware store. There's nothing special about these. So I'm just going to grab a couple, and we'll stick them on. Start with one. So there, stuck it on. Put this about halfway, and we'll see if it's enough. It certainly is not. That's going straight down again to the valve stem. And let's make sure the valve stem is actually at the bottom. Yeah, pretty much, directly. All right, so we'll put another one on here. Two weights was not enough. Three weights was too much. Since I only have one size of weight, if I had different sizes, I could have put lighter weight on there. But since I only have one size, what I had to do was spread out the center of gravity. So this is the final combination, and it took some trial and error. So I kept peeling off and putting them on, peeling off, putting them on. Once I got the weight right at the end, I put three new ones on right where those are. And now we're good. So I've gone around a couple of times.
I'm gonna hold them steady everywhere. This takes a lot of patience, if I can actually stop it from spinning to test it. That would help. So this is looking
good. Okay, we got our grease ready to go. We got one here. This is Valvoline Moly Fortified. And Moly is what you want to use on like your splines and gears. And then this other Mobil 1 synthetic grease, it's a lithium and it's used on everything smooth, such as shafts and collars and bearings and that type of thing. You can see this Moly, it's thick and this is black goop, and you don't want to get that on yourself because you're not going to get that off. And this is just this red stuff here. So what I'm gonna do, start off, I'm gonna, you see there's not too much grease that was on there. You can see a couple of clumps, but I'm gonna go ahead and clean off all the old stuff and put a light coat of Moly on there. They say you just wanna do about a pea size or so. You can use a toothbrush or take a rag, a paper towel of some sort, and dab a little and go around there. And I'm also going to put some on this side, do the same thing, clean it up, put the Moly in there, and I'm definitely going to be using gloves for this, because this is going to get dirty and you don't want to get that stuff on your hands. So with the Moly, I was reading online and there is another one that people recommend that has like, it's like 60% Moly Fortified or something. This stuff, I don't know if it says on here, but it's only like 3%. But this is the stuff that you can get anywhere. I went to Napa and I tried to ask them about some of that other stuff. And the guy basically told me, well, we don't have it here. We can't order it. It's got to go through Washington, blah, blah, blah. But the thing is, on this old bike, I'm not doing street racing or anything. And everybody says that this is plenty good. So that's what we're using. Okay, so I wiped off the old stuff and I put the new stuff all around. That's the outside, up against the side of the housing there, the inside, and then I also did a ring, a light ring around the outside here, and then did the same here, cleaned it up, and then ring around the outside, and then all in here. There is this spacer that sits in that hole there, so don't forget to put that back in. I'm going to use some of the other grease on that. And I said a pea size. I used a little bit more than that, but you can see not too much, really. I greased up the bearings. I put some grease down inside there where the axle will go, just to make sure that it is. I mean, because even if you put it on the axle, sometimes it gets squeezed out. So I wanted to just kind of pre-grease it. So with that ready to go, with this guy greased up and this one greased up, time to put the wheel back on. We'll see if I can put the camera somewhere so we can see how this does. I think all we're going to do is just lift it. I can put one of these blocks under here to help me out. Lift it and turn it a little bit. And it should go right back on here. See the teeth kind of gripping. There it goes. Nice. Okay. All right, and then this was the bar I kept fighting with. Just had to pull out a little bit. And that will go down there. Now we'll get the spacer and put that axle back in after I grease it up. So, greased up the shaft, don't forget the spacer here, and then there is the washer that goes on before the castle nut, and then the castle nut needs torqued to 60 foot-pounds, so I got my torque wrench ready to go to put that thing on there, and then there was some excess grease I had to wipe off, but we're wrapping up. Before tightening the axle nut, what we need to do is center the brakes in the drum. And to do that, what we'll do is I'll spin the wheel just a little bit, and then I will force the brake down tightly, and that will center the brakes inside the drum. So first, before I tighten the axle nut, I'm going to hook the brake back up again lightly, and then do that to center it, tighten the nut, to 60 foot-pounds, and then tighten these other guys up as they should be. Okay, so if I remember correctly, yeah, I keep these together, make sure I don't lose them. This will go in the back side of here. That sits right up against there. The washer goes on the outside, and then the nut, and then a cotter pin. So we'll do that one first. See, I took the arm off of here, so I'll get that adjusted right here in a second. Okay, this nut and bolt are in. It's just hand tight for now. And I just kind of put this in place. Forgot to mention before, when you put this back on after I greased it all up, this is supposed to be to the very right since you got new shoes on it. So I moved this over so it's about in the right place. So now I got these two guys. This one has a hole in it that sits right inside here. And this goes through it. And then
this nut tightens up on the end. So we'll do that real quick.
Get this on, actually took the arm off and put this part on first. And got it screwed in about halfway up. So that we can go either direction, but this kind of bends anyway. So now I can put it on the end. And I might need to adjust it a little bit so the teeth line up. I could actually see my line still a little bit, and that's pretty close to it. It's not on all the way. What I'm going to do is put a rag here and probably tap it with a hammer a little bit to make sure that's on, and then tighten this nut down. That's on. What works really well is I put a piece of wood here, and then I hammered the wood. You can see that that's all the way on now. So I'll put this bolt in. And I gotta check the torque specs on that. So I'll check the specs on this one, and the other one. But since it's on now, I think I can get the brake. Whoops. I don't wanna lose my cotter pin. So, see how that pops right back up? That wasn't doing that for me previously. So that's a good thing. So I'm going to center the brake drum, tighten this, and then I'll center the brake drum by forcefully stomping down on that as the wheel's spinning. Tighten the axle nut on this side to 60 foot-pounds, and then tighten that one down. I'm having an issue tightening this. It's the same problem I had getting it off. The whole freaking axle spins, so I'm just going to try to get it as tight as I can. I put this through here to stabilize on the other side, but when I'm turning on this side, the whole thing's turning. So that way I can, you know, push and pull together. I'm not too worried about it getting to 60 because there's a cotter pin. There's a cotter pin that goes through here, and that's the whole reason that this is a castle nut. So if this does come off, the cotter pin gets stuck in here, and that nut's not going to go anywhere. So I'll just get it as tight as I'm able to. The torque wrench, I was actually able to get it to 60 foot-pounds and only slightly bend my screwdriver on the other side. So now I'll put a new cotter pin in here. You should always use a new one. Whoops. There we go. Put the new cotter pin in, and then I'll use my pliers and bend it around. All right, so we're back in. Don't forget this cotter pin on this side too once this is tightened. Last thing to do is adjust how much play you got in your brake. And right now I got a little bit too much. I gotta push it down. You only want it to go down maybe an inch. But it looks like you go a little farther. So what I'm gonna do is adjust this a little bit. I'll tighten this nut, which will bring this up, so then you won't have to push this down as much. So just kind of play with that until you get it about right. You want to make sure that the wheel is fully, you know, that when you tighten this, you don't want to tighten it so much that that the brake is always on. So you want to make sure that the wheel is loose when you're doing this. Real quick, I tightened it too much, and you can hear the brakes are actually being applied without me on it. Listen, you hear the grinding? So, just need to loosen it up a little bit until we don't have that anymore. That's feeling a lot better now. All right, they say when the new tire's on, you shouldn't go over 50 miles an hour in the first 24 hours. But I'm also going to recheck the air pressure on here. Seems to be holding just fine, but double check it. I think on this bike, it's supposed to be 21 in the back, 25 in the front if you're under 220 pounds. And if you're going over that, it should be 28 or 9 in the back, 25 in the front. So if you're doing two riders or if you're a bigger person. So is that it? I think that's it.